Mr. Shot Caller, yeah, I'm back.
The música de Harry Fry.
So basically, yeah, Shot Caller came about when French had said that Flex wanted him to do like a freestyle to the beat. Because we had done the We Run New York, Watch Out We Run New York with the KRS-One sample. So then we linked up one night. I had did it, and we linked up one night, and he had Rock. And I think that's probably one of the, if not the first time I met Rock, like it had to be the second time.
Dipping in the right slow, three in the back, two if you fat, pimping is a fat.
It's your favorite coke boy, Charlie Rack, aka Mr. Shot Caller.
So basically, they came in, I pulled the beat up, played it, everybody loved it, and like 7 minutes later, Rock is like, yo, I got the hook, I'm ready. And he was kind of, initially it was like, is the hook like for French to do, or is the hook, because you know, we all contribute to whatever, so is the hook for, but then French, he said the hook, and then French was like, nah, go in there and knock it out, it sounds good. And I mean, he like one or two taped it, and that was it.
So I was in the studio, he got a track for Flex. He said he needed it for Summer Jam. I said I had it. He said, let me hear it. I put it to the beat, I already had it. Summer later, it went crazy.
And that was it, you know, and we knew, like, right there, it was like, wow, this fucking sounds incredible, you know what I'm saying? And it was kind of like, all right, and then French, you know, we all sat there, French kind of formulated his verses, you know, in the sense of, like, an old school record using the different lines and stuff, and then, you know, by the end of that session, though, it was like, yeah, we got it, you know?
It's your motherfucking nigga Chink Drugs. Your baby mom's is in the back. You know what I'm saying? We working. She giving me all the inspiration I need to get through these verses. You know what I'm saying?
Alright, when did you decide to merge into hip-hop?
Three summers ago.
So that's how long you've been rapping?
Yeah, basically.
How long have you known French Montana?
Three summers ago.
How did it come about that you featured on French Montana's Shot Caller track?
Basically just the streets and my management. Like, everybody was linked up together, so I was in the studio.
Your voice on the track has made you a hit vocal in the club. How do you feel about that?
That's swag. I'm here, just keep listening. Playing more.
Other than hip hop music, is there anything else you want to accomplish?
Oh, be number one dad.
Is there any other artists or producers you like to work with aside from the Coke Boys?
Anybody that's young, up and coming, man, I just ready to go, work hard. I'm willing to start from scratch with somebody that's real dedicated. Okay. I think that's who I need, somebody that's going to sit down and go through every sound with me.
Who's your favorite rapper?
Favorite rapper is Young Jeezy. But I say the best rapper alive is Tatakiss, hands down.
Are you looking to work with him on a track?
Both of them, hands down, that's a must.
When can we expect any new music from him?
Soon as possible, like, be in the studio right now as we speak. Once it's mixed down.
You working on your own mixtape?
Oh, definitely. Right now we working on the Coke Boy 3 mixtape. I mean, once that's out the way, that's the new NWA. I'm gonna shake the spot.
And what's gonna be the name of your new mixtape?
Well, my mixtape called Charlie. Stress that.
Alright, is there anybody you want to shout out before we wrap up?
Everybody, my whole team, Coke Boys. We here, we gonna make it. Team YG's up, you already. Charlie Rock, I'm on that Coke wave, let's get it.
Man, it's your boy Cheesy, yo, of course you know they seen me before, man. We live in the studio working on that Coke Boy 3, you know? Anyway, man, shout out Charlie Rock.